Ông quý chồng.
President, please be seated.
Le président. Veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is back in session.
Reprise des débats.
And again, the floor is given to the lead co-lawyers to put further questions to the civil party for her statement of sufferings. And please be precise and brief as possible, as the time is almost running out, and we need to give the time to other parties as well.
Reste plus de temps, il faut laisser la parole aux autres parties.
Lawyer for civil parties,
thank
you, Mr. President, for
Merci
your
Monsieur le Président, pour ce rappel.
And I only have a few last questions to
Je
be put to the civil party.
Quelques questions supplémentaires à poser à la partie civile.
Before the break, I asked you, Madame Civil Party,
avant la pause,
your
je vous ai posé des questions.
Family members.
Au sujet de votre famille.
Did you lose any of your family members, including your mother and your father?
Avez-vous perdu des membres de votre famille?
Civil Party, thank you, Mr. Lawyer.
Réponse, merci, Monsieur l'Avocat.
And before I talk about my mother and father, I'd like to add some information regarding the first January dam
website. Quelques informations supplémentaires à propos du chantier.
I recall that one day, a truck full of cement bags arrived. And workers from the mobile unit, including myself, volunteered to go and carry those cement bags off the truck.
Pour décharger.
And there were two female workers, including myself, and three male workers.
Y compris moi-même et trois hommes.
In fact, I could not carry the cement bag and
Mais
put it on my shoulder, so a male worker helped me put it on
donc,
my shoulder, and
aidé,
we could empty the truck by about 4 or 5 o'clock in
donc,
the afternoon.
Nous avons réussi à décharger le camion d'ici 4, 5, enfin, entre
and
vers
actually,
16 et 17
I hurt my back badly before
et
we could finish off the cement bags from the truck. And now allow me to return to my family members, namely my mother and father.
De ma famille, y compris mes parents.
Actually, my father, who was by himself without the rest of us, wandered and actually
Mon
arrived in Kampong Cham. He was
seul,
arrested and
marché,
subsequently killed.
Tout seul, il a marché jusqu'à Kampong Cham.
I was living
arrêté,
with my siblings
Moi, je
in Pursat province.
Ma fratrie
my
de Pursat.
Mother became sick.
Ma mère est tombée malade.
And before she died, she begged for
Et avant de mourir, elle a
the washing water of the rice grains so that she could drink it
supplier de
and
pouvoir
could
boire
regain
l'eau qui avait
some strength.
Servi à nettoyer le riz pour reprendre ses forces.
However, even the wastewater from rinsing rice grain was not given to her.
Du riz, on a refusé de lui donner.
How grateful it was for my mother. How cheap was
Quelle
her
tragédie.
Life. Even when she begged
Quelle
for
tristesse.
The wastewater, she was not allowed.
Sa
and
vie
as a result,
valait-elle si peu
died.
Qu'on ne pouvait pas lui donner de l'eau qui avait servi à laver le riz, et elle est morte.
What was the Khmer Rouge leadership thinking about?
À quoi pensaient les leaders Khmer Rouge?
Did they give value at all to my mother's life and through other Cambodians' lives who lost their lives during the regime.
La vie de mes parents
or at least they should give
a
value of the life of a cattle.
Il semblait avoir
but this is even lower
la,
than that.
À la vie
Just
du bétail.
A wastewater was not allowed
On a même pas
to give
voulu
to her.
Remettre à ma mère de l'eau qui pour laver le riz.
She begged for
Elle a supplié.
That water until her last breath. And that's what happened to my father and my mother.
Et voilà ce qui s'est passé.
When
voilà ce qui
I was in Bacchanal, we were called to
Alors que j'étais à
board
Bacchanal,
a truck.
On nous a dit de monter à bord d'un camion.
There were 20 male youths and 20 female youths.
We were instructed to
board the truck in order to harvest corn.
On nous a dit de monter à bord du camion pour aller procéder
Actually,
à la récolte du maïs.
While we were en route, Vaughan jumped out of the
Et
truck and ran into
route,
the forest.
Vaughan
and currently he lives in France.
En bas. Du
he survived the ordeal.
Camion, il s'est enfui dans la forêt et il, aujourd'hui il vit en France. Il a réussi à s'échapper.
Actually, the night that he fled, he came to ask me about his
la
wife
nuit.
And I told him
Tout
that
soir,
actually
enfui,
next day his wife was told to go and have
the
corns again.
Sa femme d'aller
he later on fled through the
maïs,
forest.
Et lui s'est enfui dans la forêt.
And my turn would come for the third day of harvesting
jour,
corn, but we were told that the corn harvest had to be postponed
per
instruction from Onca.
Cette récolte, cette
but,
mousson du
interrupt. Thank you, Madame Civil Party.
Moisson
in the
du,
interest of time.
Lord Chanty.
The,
Excusez-moi de vous interrompre,
section,
Madame,
we to thank you and Mr. President,
nous manquons de temps.
The floor
il
n'est
pas possible pour les partis civils. Je vous remercie de votre temps et nous laissons
President,
la parole aux autres
thank
partis.
You.
Le Président.
The chamber would like now to hand the floor to the co-prosecutors to put
nous
questions to the civil party if you wish to do so.
Si vous avez des questions,
that is in relation to her harm and
civile,
suffering
si
inflicted upon her during
sur,
the
le préjudice qu'elle a subi
you
et la souffrance qu'elle a endurée sous le Cambodge démocratique. Vous avez la parole.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame la Partie
Thank
civile.
You, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Madame
Mon nom est Vincent De Wilde et je vais vous
My
poser des questions
de Wilde,
au nom des co-procureurs. Ce seront essentiellement des questions sur le barrage du 1er janvier.
Focus on the first
Mais
January
avant
dam,
cela, parce que je crois que votre histoire n'a pas été tout à fait complète,
since your history
je voulais vous demander très rapidement
related
ce qui est arrivé à votre
very quickly to tell
petit frère
what
et à votre petite sœur,
younger brother and younger sister.
Pardon, ce sont deux petits frères, vos deux petits frères, CHAO
Samnang
et CHAO Savanarit.
CHAO
Samnang
and CHAO Savanarit, your younger brothers. Can you explain to us what happened to them?
Yes, I can do that.
Certainement.
My two younger brothers died from
Mes deux
illness.
Frères cadets sont morts de maladie.
Both of them died from illness, and my mother died from
ma
starvation compounded by her illness.
D'inanition et de maladie.
Merci. Je voudrais revenir à
Thank
votre
you.
Mariage.
I would like us to
visit
the
of
your marriage before talking about the working conditions on the 1st January dam work site.
Est-il correct de dire que vous
Is
vous êtes marié et que par la suite vous n'êtes plus retourné au barrage du 1er janvier?
After you got married, you never returned to the 1st January dam work site, if I properly understood your testimony.
Yes, that is correct.
C'est exact.
Tout à l'heure, vous avez dit que vous aviez été averti sur place au barrage du 1er janvier qu'il ne fallait pas refuser le mariage. Est-ce que vous pourriez nous préciser qui vous avait dit cela?
Not refuse to get married. Can you tell us who warned you not to refuse to get married?
It was the unit chief.
C'était le chef d'unité.
And the group chief.
Et le chef de groupe.
Une fois que vous êtes arrivé à la cérémonie
Once you arrive on the ceremonial grounds,
d'engagement,
you
pouvez-vous nous dire qui a présidé cette cérémonie? Est-ce qu'il y a eu un discours qui a été fait?
Who presided over that ceremony? Was any speech delivered on that occasion?
At that time, the sector committee made a speech.
À ce moment-là,
he referred to the sector 42 committee.
A prononcé un discours. Il a dit qu'il était le secteur, le comité du secteur 42.
He made a speech and said that all comrades had to achieve.
Dans son discours, que tous les camarades.
100% the work plan set out by Ankar.
Respecter à 100% la tâche que l'Ankar leur avait confiée.
He also said that the wheel of history. Moved forward
que la roue de l'histoire
will not move avancer backward.
Sans jamais revenir en arrière.
For that reason, it's incumbent upon us to achieve the work plan set out by Ankar.
Il était important que nous complétions la tâche que Ankar nous avait confiée.
Then we made the so-called solemn declaration.
Puis nous avons prononcé notre serment.
To abide by the line of Ankar.
Nous avons juré de
and
suivre
to
les
achieve
100%
of the work plan set out by Ankar. And then we said, long live the great leap forward.
Au plan de l'Ankar. Et ensuite nous avons dit, vive le grand bond vers l'avant.
Vous avez parlé de tâches qui étaient confiées par l'Ankar. Quelle était la tâche qu'on vous confiait en vous mariant? Qu'est-ce qu'on attendait des mariés?
What was expected of the married couple?
My apology. In fact, I think I made a mistake. I just spoke about the first January dam
website.
As for the commitment that we had to make
donc,
for the
prendre,
wedding ceremony,
we instructed
to make a solemn declaration that we recognize each other as husband and wife. And that we had to follow the line of
Ankar
and follow whatever directions or instructions set out by Ankar, namely the task of building dam or digging canal.
De construire des barrages, de
we had to commit ourselves to follow such work plan through.
À suivre le plan de travail.
And to fulfill such work plans.
Je vous demandais ces questions parce que dans le formulaire de formation supplémentaire qui
était,
se trouve au dossier, le D22-339A, je crois, en Khmer 0058-6027 et en anglais 01-09-86-24. Il est dit que les autorités vous avaient dit que vous deviez vous marier pour faire des bébés pour l'Ankar. Est-ce que c'est quelque chose qu'on vous a dit? Est-ce que vous confirmez cela?
I don't think I make that statement.
Je ne crois pas avoir dit cela.
I don't think about making babies at all.
Je ne pense pas que j'ai parlé de faire
However,
bébé.
We were instructed to make our commitment to the work plan of Ankar.
On nous a dit qu'il fallait nous engager envers le plan de travail de l'Ankar.
Vous faisiez partie, lorsque vous étiez au barrage du 1er janvier, de la brigade mobile du secteur 42.
Of, the mobile brigade
comment était-elle organisée? Est-ce qu'elle avait une structure militaire? Et si oui, quelle était cette structure? Si vous en avez connaissance.
That structure composed of, if you do remember.
Allow me to clarify the matter. In fact,
laissez-moi apporter une précision.
I did not know whether the mobile unit belongs to the army or not.
Si cette unité mobile était rattachée à l'armée ou non.
There was an announcement that we were part of the sector 42 mobile unit.
Il a été annoncé que nous faisions partie de l'unité mobile du secteur
42. Three sectors involved in the building of the dam.
Trois secteurs sector participaient à la construction 41, 42, du barrage, les secteurs 41, 42 43 et 43.
Et dans votre unité, combien y avait-il de personnes et quels étaient les échelons qui étaient au-dessus de votre unité?
And what were the echelons above your unit?
I only know two individuals, namely Comrade Kim and Comrade Srien.
Comrade Kim et Srien.
Comrade Srien was our unit chief.
Srien était notre chef d'unité.
Actually, Comrade Srien died during the regime
because
of the accusation of a moral affair.
On l'a accusé d'inconduite morale.
Et la fonction du camarade Kim, quelle était cette fonction?
And what was Comrade Kim's functions?
I am not 100% certain. However, from my recollection, Comrade Kim was in charge of the Sector 42 mobile unit.
Était à la tête de l'unité mobile du secteur 42.
Pour clarifier, tout à l'heure, vous avez parlé de travail de jour.
Vous avez dit
que vous vous leviez très tôt, à 4h du matin, et que vous travailliez jusqu'à 17h avec un repas entre qui coupait la journée en deux. Vous avez également fait état de travail de nuit jusqu'à 22h, 22h, 23h, et que vous deviez guider Cam Pao. À part ce travail de guide, est-ce que vous avez travaillé vous-même à porter de la terre pendant la nuit ou en soirée?
Transport earth during the night or in the evening?
At night time, when we finish carrying the dirt,
la nuit,
I had to hold hand of Kompo and guided her to the sleeping quarters.
J'ai dû guider, enfin prendre Kompo par la main et la guider
jusqu'au dortoir. We arrived at the sleeping quarter.
Quand nous sommes arrivés au dortoir,
we did not do anything else because it was almost midnight already. I was so exhausted.
J'étais épuisé.
I just fell onto the floor.
Je suis tombé par terre.
And I was not even yet in my deep sleep, and I was woken by the whistle blowing.
Bien endormi que le coup de sifflet retentissait.
Combien de mètres cubes demandait-on aux travailleuses de votre unité transporter par jour?
Of earth did the workers in your unit have to transport a day?
I cannot recall that precisely. I have lost a part of my recollection.
J'ai perdu la mémoire quelque peu.
Because I worked at various locations and the work quota varied.
J'ai travaillé à différents endroits et les
usually,
quotas de travail
the quota is,
en général,
two cubic meters
c'était 2 mètres cubes
each worker,
par travailleur.
But we had to work in a team of three.
Mais il fallait travailler en équipe
and
de trois.
We had to have the our peer within the team et if one were not to complete the work quota for that day.
Si cette personne ne parvenait pas à respecter le quota pour la journée.
Il y a un sujet qui m'intéresse particulièrement parce que vous avez expliqué avoir travaillé comme personnel médical militaire. Vous qui aviez quelques connaissances en matière médicale, comment pouvez-vous nous parler de la qualité des soins qui étaient fournis aux travailleurs sur le site du 1er janvier par les aides-soignants sur place?
Healthcare workers on that site.
In fact, I saved a person's life.
J'ai sauvé la vie
the person actually is still living in Totempong area at the present time.
Du marché russe.
She was so emaciated while she was still staying in the hospital.
Elle était
and actually,
toute
the medical staff was in a rush at the time to try to inject her with some
de
liquid,
faire des injections
and liquid she was gasping for air.
Alors qu'elle cherchait à respirer.
And then I offered my hand, that is to put the needle into her
vein. Si je pouvais aider, c'est-à-dire les aider
the medical staff could not do it.
Le personnel médical ne parvenait pas à trouver.
And luckily, I could manage to put the needle in so the serum could flow through.
Mettre la seringue dans la veine pour que le sérum puisse circuler.
And then I begged that medical staff not to report that I had some medical experience to her superior.
De ne pas faire rapport du fait que j'avais des connaissances médicales à leur supérieur.
And as I said, that woman survived and she is now selling jewelry at the Totempong market.
Et elle me vend aujourd'hui des bijoux au marché.
Est-ce que ce personnel médical à l'époque était correctement formé
et disposait
de médicaments suffisants pour traiter les travailleurs et notamment ceux qui étaient malades sur le chantier?
Particularly those who were taken ill on the work site.
To my knowledge, no.
À ma connaissance, non.
To my knowledge, there was no medicine that was effective for such treatment. I did not know the medical condition of that woman, but apparently she was so skinny.
Enfin, quelle maladie affligeait
and
cette personne?
I noticed
si
that the medical staff was trying her best to insert the needle in, but she failed to do so.
La seringue, mais ne parvenait pas à trouver la veine.
So from my observation that medical staff did not receive any proper training
personnel médical n'avait pas reçu la formation
in
nécessaire.
This area because he could not even manage to insert a needle into the vein of a patient.
Merci. Tout à l'heure, vous avez parlé de disparition.
Thank
vous avez dit que lors des réunions,
ago,
vous ne saviez pas que les personnes qui étaient critiquées disparaîtraient par la suite.
Those who were criticized disappeared thereafter.
À l'endroit où vous dormiez, est-ce que vous constatiez des disparitions?
Did you observe any
ou bien,
disappearances?
Pendant la journée, lorsque vous travailliez, est-ce que vous constatiez également que des personnes, des collègues disparaissaient de manière régulière?
Some persons, notably colleagues of yours, disappeared regularly.
People disappeared after the criticism and self-criticism meetings.
Après les réunions de critique
people disappeared continuously. However, what we heard was that this worker was not active in carrying out the work. For that reason, he or she was sent for re-education. But we did not know what happened to that worker.
Nous ne savions pas ce qui arrivait à ce travail.
And the worker never reappeared.
Et jamais on ne le revoyait.
And that happened continuously.
Et ça s'est produit avec fréquence.
Peut-être une ou deux dernières questions. Est-ce que sur le chantier, vous étiez soumis à une surveillance? On observait la façon dont vous vous acquittiez de vos tâches au quotidien.
As you went about doing your daily work, were you monitored?
On the issue of monitoring, not only it happened at the first Dunedin work site, but also happened elsewhere. We had to be very mindful of what we said, or whether we whispered to one another, or we signaled to one another. Even a sibling saw one another working nearby, did not dare speaking to one another. I myself was on my own while I was working there without any relatives.
Est-ce qu'il y a des gens qui ont essayé de fuir le chantier à l'époque, ou est-ce que vous-même, vous avez pensé à vous enfuir étant donné les conditions de vie et de travail sur place?
Think of fleeing, given the living conditions and working conditions on that work site.
Actually, I made an attempt to flee the work site.
J'ai essayé une fois de m'enfuir.
I was, as I said earlier, allowed to visit the works, the cooperative, but actually such authorization was given only to base people. But I actually saw a permission or authorization letter,
j'ai vu une,
and I noticed the signature of
comrade
Kim on that letter.
Kim
so
passer,
I made a fake letter with a similar signature to go to the cooperative. And that, as a result, I obtained rice and sugar. So I made the fake letter and I could do that.
Voilà.
J'ai
réussi à y aller.
Pouvez-vous préciser à quel moment est-ce que cela s'est passé? Est-ce que c'était avant que vous étiez vous travailliez au barrage du 1er janvier ou bien pendant la construction du barrage?
Before you started working,
et si oui, est-ce que cela s'est vu? Est-ce qu'on a remarqué votre absence?
And if such a thing happened, was your absence noticed?
Yes, my absence was noticed.
On a remarqué que j'étais absente.
I went away from the work site once in a while because I knew that sooner or later I would die, the day would come.
Qu'un jour j'allais mourir, qu'il viendrait bien
so
me chercher.
I had to do that before I died.
Et je devais le faire avant de mourir.
I knew that I might die, but I had to fake the letter to present it to the military and the cooperative in order to obtain some rice and sugar. I did that in order to survive for that period of time.
C'est grâce à ça.
Although I knew that I would die sooner or later, and I did not dare to remain longer at the cooperative, as I knew once I arrived at the work site, I would be criticized.
On m'aurait critiqué.
Merci, je ne crois pas que j'ai encore de temps, Monsieur le Président, je vais m'arrêter là, au nom des co-procureurs. Merci, Madame le Parti civil.
On behalf of the prosecution, thank you very much, Madame Civil Party.
President, thank you. Now the floor is given to the defense teams for the accused, starting first from the defense team for Mr. Nguyen Chia. You may put questions to the civil party in relation to sufferings endured by the civil party. You may now proceed. Lawyer Liu Sovana. Good afternoon, Mr. President, Your Honours, everyone in and around the courtroom. My name is Liu Sovana. I am the lawyer for Mr. Nguyen Chia. Good afternoon, Madam Civil Party. I will have some questions to put to you. You made mention that you have three children. Could you tell the court when they were born? Answer. Thank you, lawyer. My first child was born in 1980. And the second one was born in 1983, and the last child was born in 1985. Question. When did you divorce your husband?
À quel moment avez-vous divorcé de votre mari?
Answer.
Réponse.
I divorced my husband in perhaps 1988 or 1989.
Peut-être.
Question.
Can you tell the court the reason you divorced your husband? Vous avez divorcé de votre mari.
Answer. Thank you, Mr. Lawyer.
Réponse. Merci.
The reason of the divorce.
La raison du divorce.
Is that we were forced.
Que nous avons été forcés.
Get married during the Khmer Rouge period,
and Khmer Rouge.
our parents,
et nos parents, mes parents,
were not satisfied with our marriage.
N'étaient pas contents de ce mariage.
And my parents-in-law.
Mes beaux-parents
were not satisfied with me. They wanted to have a better daughter-in-law, perhaps. And this is the reason why I divorced my husband.
Que j'ai divorcé de mon mari.
Question. So, is it true to say that your divorce resulted from
est-il exact alors de dire que votre divorce est le résultat
problem
d'un désaccord familial?
This divorce does not result from your relationship.
De votre relation?
Answer.
Réponse.
In my opinion.
À mon avis. the divorce was caused by the, our forced marriage
le divorce
in the
est
Khmer
le résultat
Rouge
de notre
time.
Mariage forcé à l'époque des Khmer Rouges.
I do not know whether my opinion is right or wrong,
je ne sais
Mr.
pas si
Lawyer.
J'ai tort ou si j'ai raison, si mon opinion est correcte ou erronée.
Question. You made Question. Mention that you divorced your husband because of a family situation or problem,
situation
and because the in-law family looked down on you,
parce que
and they said that you were an orphan. So could you expand a little bit more on this?
Vous. Pourriez-vous nous en dire davantage?
Answer.
Réponse.
The cause of the divorce was the forced marriage in the Khmer Rouge period. And another cause of the divorce was the family trouble. My in-law considered me as an orphan, as a person without clear goal and direction, so I decided
clair.
To leave
Donc,
the house and divorce
j'ai décidé
my
de
husband.
La maison et de divorcer de mon mari.
Lawyer.
Avocat.
You made mention that the cause of the reason, one of it was the forced marriage in
the
Khmer Rouge
divorce,
time.
Le forcé qui avait eu lieu
it was because of
Rouge.
The forced marriage in the Khmer Rouge period. Why did you not divorce your husband
si
immediately
cas,
after the fault of the regime in 1979?
Juste après la chute du régime en 1979?
Answer. I would like to clarify this point for you, Mr. Lawyer, why I did not immediately divorce my husband after the fall of the regime. I could not be able to make a decision at that time because I had no idea where I was going. And I did not know what would happen to me. I was not aware whether or not I would meet my relatives or family members.
De ma famille.
And it's the same for my husband.
Et il en allait de même pour mon mari.
After we found our family members
une fois que nous avons
of my
membres
husband's
de notre famille,
side, and we went to his birth
de mon mari,
village,
nous nous sommes rendus
built
dans
a house to live in.
Vous
at that time, my husband changed his mind
mon mari
to have a wealthier wife. I mean, my in-laws, a family, wanted
a
wealthier
une
wife for my husband. The divorce was not because of our relationship. It was because the in-law family was not satisfied with me, was not happy with me. That is why I decided to leave the house and divorce my husband. Lawyer. Do you recall whether you have filled in the victim information form?
Vous souvenez-vous avoir rempli le formulaire de renseignement sur les victimes?
Answer, yes, I have filled in the victim
oui,
information
j'ai
form.
Rempli ce formulaire.
Question.
Question.
Does the information in the form reflect what you
Est-ce
stated before this court?
Reflète bien ce que vous avez dit à la chambre.
Answer. Yes. Why not?
Réponse oui. Pourquoi ça ne serait pas le cas?
It is my account in the victim's information form, and the account was written in the information form.
C'est ce que j'ai relaté. Ce que j'ai relaté figure dans le formulaire.
Question.
Question.
In your first application form, you made no mention about the forced marriage. Why did this happen?
Pourquoi?
Answer. The information about the forced marriage was not put in the victim's information form because there were no questions asking me about the forced marriage. Later on, I was asked about my marriage, and in my reply, I said I got married in Khmer Rouge time. Yes, of course. I did not fill in the information in relation to my marriage, my first marriage in the first form, but in the second one, I actually put in the information. Question. Before the break, you stated that you were a medical staff in Battambang province in the former regime.
Que vous faisiez partie However, in the dans la province de Battambang,
victim's information form, document D22/339, and D22/339.1
at a French en français
00 84 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 69 49. Before 1975, I lived in Swairien, I was a medic. I live with my four siblings. I was the first. I have other siblings, Chao Somnang, Chao Sawanarang. I, Chao Lang, was a medical staff at Prasod military barrack. Can you tell the court why the statement in the victim information form is not consistent with what you have told the court?
Dans le formulaire de renseignement sur les victimes ne correspond pas à ce que vous avez dit devant la chambre.
Answer. Mr. Lawyer, I never stated that I was a medical staff at Prasod military barrack. It is true that I was working as a medical staff in Siem Reap province. The hospital at that time was known as Kat Songkat Hospital or 404 Hospital. I never mentioned that I was working at a Prasod at all. I was a student at that time in Swairien.
In
1972, I moved to work in Siem Reap province.
J'ai déménagé lawyer. Pour travailler dans la province
Let
de Siem Reap.
Me clarify this
Avocat.
Point with you.
Permettez que je
in the same document,
dans le même document,
you stated that you were evacuated from Swairien and you were transferred to Phnom Penh in 1975. However, a little bit before,
un peu avant,
earlier you stated that you were moving to live in Swahirien, and in the document you stated that you stay together with your family members, and during the fall of the regime, you, together with your family members, were traveling to Phnom Penh. So why the answer? Why is the answer not consistent with what you have told the court? President interrupts. You may now proceed, Counsel Pei-Ang. Counsel Pei-Ang. Good afternoon, Mr. President, lawyer, national lawyer for Nuon Chia. Referred to the victim's information form without specifying EON numbers in three languages. So please ask Mr. President as a national lawyer to provide your references. Lawyer, EON in English and French are the same. 00 48 48 35, that is Khmer Eon. I quote, in April 1975, Khmer Rouge defeated Lon Nol regime completely. I, Chao Lang, recalled what Collado McDonough told me to hide the background. I and my father laid down the weapon, and my father took off the military uniform and leave mingle with the villagers. A few days later, Khmer Rouge, with the black clothes, came to tell the villagers that all comrades, now the Khmer Rouge control the country, and you were all required to live in the rural areas, in the provinces, to do rice farming for the development of the country. At 9 a.m., everyone left Swahirien for Phnom Penh via Nhat Luang. It is in the same page, EON number. When we arrived in Phnom Penh, everyone went to find rice to cook.
Tout le monde est allé chercher du riz à cuisiner.
And my father, Chao Sang, went to find food supplies so that we could use on the way to Swahirien. And my father told my mother to look after the children so that they did not wander off. So can you explain to the court about the inconsistency in your victim application form? You stated that you were separated. You were not staying together with your family member during the evacuation. However, in the application form, you made mention that you and your family members were together.
Votre famille étiez ensemble.
Civil party, let me clarify the point for you.
Permettez que je vous clarifie tout cela.
It is not true what you have quoted. So I told the court in the morning already. It is my true account. I visited Kien Swai a few days before the Khmer New Year. I was playing a traditional game, Bahong Kun, at that time. My parents were staying together in Phnom Penh.
Étaient à Phnom Penh et habitaient ensemble à Phnom Penh.
When the country almost fell to Khmer Rouge, my father was trying to find me at Dayat. And he came to told me to withdraw all the money from Khmer Bank.
Que je devais retirer tout lawyer interrupted. Des banques Khmer. L'avocat interrompt.
Madame Civil Party, I would like to know about evacuation.
J'aimerais
you
avoir des informations
made
sur
mention
l'évacuation.
In this court that you were not staying together with your family member
que
during the evacuation. However, in the victim information form, you made mention that you were with your parents and siblings.
Vous étiez avec vos parents et votre fratrie.
And you also stated
vous dites
that
également
your father went to Kampong Cham where he was arrested and your mother was living in the Po Sat with your siblings. Once again, in your victim's information form, you stated, I quote, I, Chao Lang, and my mother, Sun Sukhong, were walking very slowly, waiting for my father, Chao Sang, to arrive. However, we did not see our father.
Mais nous n'avons pas vu notre père.
Chao Sang, my father,
Chao Sang,
disappeared, perhaps because he was arrested by Khmer Rouge, he was in his uniform. We at the time traveled until we reached Kampong Cham. And upon our arrival, Khmer Rouge divided people into groups and put in different villages so that they were able to control all people. My family was asked to live in Chamkalo, Kampong Cham province. Once again, why are there many consistencies within the information
Pourquoi
application
y a-t-il de
form?
Incohérences, hein, par rapport à, au formulaire?
Rather, with, in the victim information form.
Le renseignement sur les victimes.
Answer.
Réponse.
I did not state about the point you have just said, that is, I was together with my family members. I recall very well the time when I met my husband, and after that time, I was separated from my family members. Lawyer, thank you, civil party. I am concluded with my line of questioning, Mr. President. President, now the chamber gives the floor to the defense team for Mr. Kirsenpon. You may proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame la partie civile. Je m'appelle Anta Guissé et je suis coavocat international de Monsieur Kirsenpon. Je vais également vous poser quelques questions de précision par rapport à votre déposition. Je vais m'intéresser tout d'abord à la période au cours de laquelle vous avez travaillé sur le barrage du 1er janvier. Vous avez évoqué un incident avec votre collègue qui souffrait de cécité nocturne, en indiquant que c'est grâce à l'intervention de trois responsables qu'on a pu donner des instructions au chef de groupe pour qu'il arrête de faire travailler votre collègue la nuit. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition ?
Yes, it is true.
Réponse oui, c'est exact.
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez du nom de ces trois responsables qui sont intervenus?
Of these three people who intervened.
What I can recall is that
ce dont je me souviens,
the three individuals
c'est que les trois individus
were the senior leaders.
Étaient les dirigeants en chef.
Why I
dirigeants.
Say so? Because they use the scarves, a beautiful scarf, to wrap around their necks. And I
dans
can understand that those who had beautiful scarves to wrap around their necks had high-ranking positions.
De la gorge, occupaient des postes de haut niveau.
Et est-ce que vous avez su leur nom?
And did you know their names?
Oui.
I do not know their names.
Je ne connais pas leur nom.
However, I know that they were in high-ranking position, that is, when they had seal scarves around their necks, they held a high position.
C'est à cela que j'ai su qu'ils occupaient un poste de haut niveau.
Est-ce que vous saviez s'ils occupaient des postes au niveau du district, au niveau de la commune,
know if they had
ou ailleurs?
Position, at the commune or district level or elsewhere?
Let me clarify the point for you.
Je vais vous clarifier cela.
To my knowledge, I heard clearly from my unit chief or group chiefs that on that day the senior leaders or people came to visit the place, the area where I worked, and I noticed there were three of them at the work site.
Est-ce que vous avez vu des grands dirigeants à plusieurs reprises lorsque vous travaillez sur le site du 1er janvier?
On several occasions when you were working on the 1 January dam site?
It was only once when I saw the senior leader. It was the time also when I guided the one who had the night blindness.
Est-ce que vous connaissiez Pol Pot à l'époque
you know
vous travailliez sur le site du 1er janvier?
Back then, when you were working at the January 1 dam site.
At that time, I did not know. However, I heard people say
Pol
Pot came to visit the site. I did not know that guy Pol Pot at that time.
Je vous dis ça, madame, parce que dans
votre
déclaration
E3,
enfin votre formulaire de victime E3/59665, en français 00846972, en khmer 00484836. Il n'y a pas de traduction en anglais spécifiquement de cette déclaration. Ok, il paraît qu'il faut que je redonne les ERN. Donc en khmer, 00484836. Et en anglais, il n'y a pas de traduction de ce document en particulier, mais le contenu se retrouve également au document E319/27.4.13 et en anglais, c'est l'ERN 01098616. Voilà ce que vous dites dans ma version en français. Tous les mois, Pol Pot se rendait une ou deux fois au chantier où il nous disait de nous efforcer de travailler pour notre pays. Ma question est donc la suivante. Avez-vous vu pendant la période au cours de laquelle vous avez travaillé sur le site du 1er janvier, tous les mois,
Pol Pot
vous encourager à travailler pour votre pays?
To work hard for your country.
Answer. Although Pol Pot was there at the work site on a frequent
fréquemment.
Basis or not, I did not know him personally.
Je ne le connaissais pas personnellement.
And also, I did not know his physical appearance.
Je ne savais pas à quoi
il ressemblait. I did not know how many times he visited the work site.
En visite
group
sur le site
and
de travail.
Unit chiefs
les chefs de groupe et les
told
chefs d'unité
us that we had to work hard
que nous devions travailler dur.
On the day because
ce jour-là.
Big Anka
parce que le grand
came to visit the site.
En visite sur le site.
And meetings were convened within the sector 42 to encourage us to work hard, as I stated earlier before this court.
Ma question est plus précise. Est-ce que vous avez dit lors de l'établissement de votre formulaire que Pol Pot venait tous les mois sur le site du barrage du 1er janvier.
To the One January Dam work site.
Answer. Let me tell you, Madame Lawyer.
Madame l'avocat,
I made mention very clearly that Paul.
Bien clairement.
I said that Paul Pot perhaps went to the work site three times only, and I told you already that I did not know Paul Pot personally. I did not know his physical appearance at that time. I only knew that there were people from the center office coming to the site, and there were meetings convened during the time of the visits.
Lorsque ces personnes visitaient.
If I am not mistaken, the meetings were convened very frequently at the district
ces réunions
level.
Étaient organisées fréquemment au niveau du district.
As for Pol Pot, he may have visited the site a few times, but
qu'il soit venu sur le
site did not know anything
else. Mais je n'en savais rien d'autre à ce sujet à l'époque.
Donc, si je comprends bien, quand vous avez établi votre formulaire, vous avez dit il est possible que Pol Pot soit venu. Parce que lorsqu'on lit votre formulaire, on voit ça comme une affirmation et on a l'impression que vous avez vous-même assisté à ses visites. Donc, si je comprends bien, et je vous demande de me rectifier si je commets une erreur, vous avez émis la possibilité d'une présence de Pol Pot. C'est bien ça.
Answer. I would like to clarify the point for you, lawyer.
A group Madame, j'aimerais vous préciser la
and
question.
Unit chiefs told me that Pol Pot came to visit the site on that day, and I was told that he was in a senior position, and I did not know Pol Pot personally, as I told you.
Mais moi,
I
ne
heard
le pas
a group and unit chiefs tell
c'est
me
les chefs d'unité
about
de groupe
the
qui
visit
m'ont parlé
that
de cette visite.
Pol Pot came.
C'est eux qui m'ont dit que Pol Pot venait.
Once again, I heard from
fois,
someone else, the
c'est
unit
quelqu'un
and
d'autre
group
qui
chiefs.
Me l'a dit. C'était les chefs de groupe
I
d'unité.
I did not know Pol Pot personally.
Moi,
I did not know even his face.
Et je ne savais même pas reconnaître son visage.
D'accord, donc vous me parlez
fine.
D'une visite.
So
donc, moi, ce que je cherche à comprendre,
so
c'est pourquoi il est marqué dans votre formulaire qu'il y avait, alors, dans le formulaire en français et en khmer, il y a marqué une ou deux fois au chantier. Est-ce que une ou deux fois par mois
hein? Once or twice per month, in fact.
Ma question
so
est, ça ne vient pas de vous, les une ou deux fois par mois
you are not the one who has that. Where does that information come from? You did not provide that information.
Answer. Let me clarify the point once again. At the first January dam work site, while I was working there,
au chantier du barrage du 1er janvier, quand moi j'y travaillais,
did not work there on a permanent basis.
Je n'ai pas travaillé là en permanence.
Someone told me about the visit.
Quelqu'un m'a parlé
the visit of Pol Pot.
Pol Pot.
Someone told me on the day that Pol Pot came to the place.
Le jour où il est venu.
I noticed that there were three people on the stage, and someone told me specifically on that day that one among them was Pol Pot.
Je vous remercie de cette précision.
Thank you for this clarification.
Toujours des précisions par rapport
Now,
à ce que vous avez dit
again,
et par rapport à ce qui figure dans votre déclaration. J'ai cru comprendre au début de votre déposition que vous avez évoqué votre travail auprès d'une femme d'origine philippine et au cours de votre déposition ce matin, j'ai compris qu'elle était colonelle en charge de stocker des explosifs. C'est ce que j'ai entendu en français. Est-ce que vous pouvez me confirmer ce point ?
So, can you confirm this to me?
Answer. I can tell you once again about that person, Poliro Rabbit. She was a colonel.
Cette personne,
she was
Rabbit.
In charge of explosive,
des
all kinds of explosive, restoring them in the warehouse.
En
he was the one who
Il
was tasked with monitoring the transportation of explosives from the aircraft into the warehouse.
Explosifs depuis les aéronefs jusque dans l'entrepôt.
C'était un homme ou c'était une femme?
Was it a man or a woman?
Yeah. Answer. I would like to make it clear.
J'aimerais dire clairement.
He was a male.
C'était un homme.
He was a colonel.
Il
His
était
age
colonel.
Was about 51 or 52
il
years
avoir
old
51
at that time.
Ans.
His bureau or office was close to
Son
that.
Bureau.
To close to my office.
Était assez près du mien.
I learned that the person was in charge of explosives.
Et j'ai su que cette personne était responsable des
Yaim,
munitions.
Who was a
de
captain.
Yaim,
I was the stepdaughter.
Moi,
I was the goddaughter of Yaim at that time. So I learned the background of the Filipino colonel from the Yaim, the captain.
C'est le capitaine Yaim qui m'a parlé de ce colonel philippin. Et ce Yaim était aussi mon père adoptif.
Je vous dis ça, madame, parce que dans votre déclaration E3, dans votre formulaire E3-5965, à l'URN en Khmer 00484834, et en anglais, vous allez avoir la traduction correspondante sur le document E3-29/27.4.13 à l'URN suivant 01-09-86-15. Malheureusement, il n'y a pas de traduction en français, donc je vais vous lire ce que l'on lit sur votre déclaration, votre formulaire, en anglais. I was working cooperatively with a female Filipino medical doctor
avec un médecin philippin, c'était une femme,
whose name was Corrado Prasut,
dont le nom était
Corrado-Damit, pardon.
Corrado-Damit.
In March 1975, due to the social unrest inside the country, Corrado-Damit went back to the Philippines, our home country. Fin de citation.
End of quote.
Donc, ma question est de savoir si cette personne venant des Philippines était bien colonel en charge du transport de munitions ou est-ce que c'était une femme médecin avec laquelle vous avez travaillé? Alors, on m'indique que dans la traduction en khmer, il y a peut-être une erreur, donc je répète ma question de savoir si cette personne des Philippines était un colonel homme en charge du transport de munitions ou bien un médecin femme avec laquelle vous avez travaillé au sein d'un hôpital militaire.
Answer, to be clear for everyone,
eh bien, j'aimerais que ce soit clair pour tout le monde.
I was a medical staff.
Moi, je faisais partie du personnel médical.
At 404 hospital.
À l'hôpital 404.
And Corrado-Damit.
Et cette personne des Philippines.
Was the one who was in charge of ammunition or explosives.
Cette personne s'occupait des explosifs ou des munitions.
Transported from the United States, and he was monitoring the transportation of explosives into the warehouse. His office was at one site close to the hospital. The hospital was separated in two parts, and his office was close to the hospital.
Proche de l'hôpital.
That colonel was a friend of my adoptive father,
Peng
Yang, the captain. He was not a medical staff, he was a colonel in charge of storing explosives or ammunition.
Et est-ce que nous sommes d'accord que vous situez cette période à peu près enfin, en 75, dans le premier trimestre 75.
During the first quarter of 1975, is that correct?
Yeah.
Answer. Yes.
Oui.
Monsieur. Le président, je suis consciente
Mr.
du
President,
temps qui s'est écoulé. Là, je vois qu'il est presque 4h15. J'ai encore 5 minutes de questions, si vous m'autorisez, pour pouvoir terminer la partie d'aujourd'hui et ne pas avoir à la faire terminer, enfin, revenir demain si ce n'est pas nécessaire.
It's not necessary to bring the civil party back tomorrow.
President, you may proceed with your line, with your questioning,
until
you conclude it. And court officer, please communicate the information to the concerned offices and chambers so that the transportation
are
available to transport staff back to town.
You may now proceed. Plus tard. Vous avez la parole.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Je vais essayer d'être brève. J'en reviens maintenant à la période au cours de laquelle vous avez travaillé sur le barrage du 1er janvier. Et vous avez évoqué une période au cours de laquelle vous êtes tombé malade et vous avez eu de la fièvre. Et vous avez évoqué l'aide de votre ami qui souffrait de cécité nocturne, CHAO, si je me souviens bien, en expliquant qu'elle avait fait un remède à base de feuilles de képok qu'elle vous avait fait boire et mis en quête à place. Dans la mesure où vous avez indiqué avoir une formation médicale, ma question est la suivante. Est-ce que ces méthodes traditionnelles étaient fréquentes à l'époque au Cambodge?
Traditional methods, can you tell us whether these traditional methods were frequent in Cambodia back then?
Answer. We had no choice at that time.
Nous n'avions pas le choix à l'époque.
no modern medicines.
Il n'y avait pas de médicaments
only the so-called rabbit dropping pellets that were available at that time.
Des crottes de lapin.
Based on our experience as a medical staff, we had no choice but to resort to those kind of traditional healing.
I was
trying to drink the water made out of compost leaves.
Boire la décoction
later on,
de
I could recover from the illness.
Et j'ai pu me rétablir.
Whether I trusted in the traditional medicine at that time, I had to drink
je n'avais pas
the
le choix
traditional
de faire confiance aux médicaments traditionnels. Je devais boire.
I believe that the water made out of compost leaves could partially heal my disease at that time, but I believe in modern medicine
mais moi, je
better.
Crois en la médecine. Je pense que la médecine moderne est meilleure.
À ce propos, j'ai compris de votre déposition tout à l'heure que vous avez indiqué que vous avez également eu. Alors, j'ai compris d'abord que c'était des pilules traditionnelles, et puis vous avez également évoqué de l'aspirine, en disant que vous avez reconnu de l'aspirine. Est-ce que vous pouvez m'indiquer qui vous a remis ce cachet d'aspirine, et est-ce qu'il s'agit bien des soignants qui étaient sur le barrage à ce moment-là?
Answer. The medic was on standby at the work site.
Il y avait un aide-soignant sur place.
With the help of aspirin tablet, it could cure my disease. I was in a serious situation at that time in relation to my disease.
Grâce à un comprimé d'aspirine,
and
très malade.
Put up her hands together and a bag for the aspirin tablet for me. No one recognized the medicine at that time, but I had the experience and I could recognize that the tablet was aspirin. Let me tell you, was very difficult to find modern medicine, including aspirin. It was my luck, it was my fortune to have the medicine aspirin.
Grande chance pour moi d'avoir accès de l'aspirine.
Et ce sera mon dernier point. Vous avez indiqué avoir été envoyé en rééducation avec deux autres de vos camarades après avoir refusé de quitter une coopérative. Et dans votre déclaration E3/5965, il est indiqué que... Alors, je vais prendre la référence en anglais du document E319/27.4.13 à l'URN en anglais 0109816161 6. Et je vais citer en anglais. Vous évoquez, pour résumer, le moment où vous êtes retourné chez votre mère et vous dites que vous avez quitté votre endroit d'affectation pendant 3 jours. Et quand vous êtes revenu, voilà ce que vous dites en anglais. When I arrived, the three chiefs of the unit, one of whom was Takim, called me to be re-educated. Ma question est la suivante. Est-ce que vous avez fait l'objet de plusieurs rééducations à savoir une fois lorsque vous avez refusé de quitter la coopérative et une fois après vous être absenté sans autorisation pour aller votre mère, ou est-ce que c'est une confusion dans le cadre de votre déclaration, votre formulaire de déclaration de partie civile?
Answer. They came to take me back. The purpose was not to re-educate me, but to encourage me back to work. I was chained at that time, and I was reprimanded from the morning until the evening.
Toute la journée.
At the time that they came to collect me,
quand ils sont venus me chercher,
they lied to me that they wanted me to be in the meeting.
Ils ont dit
but
que
in fact, they wanted me to go back
en fait,
and work in the cooperative.
Ça, j'ai compris sur le moment où vous deviez quitter la coopérative. Ma question, et ce sera ma dernière si c'est clair, c'est est-ce que lorsque vous êtes revenu des trois jours après votre mère, vous avez fait l'objet d'une rééducation oui ou non?
Returned from visiting your mother for three days, were you subjected to re-education or not?
I was walked back to their place. And a meal, dinner, was given to me. I was reprimanded at that time. I was refreshed. And they said, you, comrade, stop doing such a thing later on. Now, Anka begged you to go back to work. Make sure you were careful.
Eh bien,
you
attention.
Are careful. Next time, it
fois,
will be your time to beg Anka, not Anka begging you. So it was said at that time.
C'est ce qu'ils m'ont dit.
Monsieur le Président, compte tenu du temps, je vais m'en arrêter là.
Mr. President, given that my time has run out, I will stop now.
President, thank you, lawyer.
Merci.
It is now time for the adjournment.
Le moment est venu
and
de lever l'audience.
The chamber will continue its hearing tomorrow on the 2nd of
nous
September 2015. You may not
proceed.
Council,
Maître Pican, vous avez la parole.
As I noticed, you are on your
je
feet.
Je vois que vous demandez la parole.
Lawyer, but, Mr. President, my apologies to interrupt you, but you have not yet given the floor to civil party to put questions to the accused.
Donné la parole à la partie civile pour qu'il puisse poser les questions.
Chao Lang, you have the floor now. If you have any questions to if you have a question to put to the accused, to the president of the chamber, that is me. You may not proceed.
C'est-à-dire moi, je vous laisse la parole.
Civil party. Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon.
Merci,
once again, Mr. President,
bon après-midi, une
and
fois de plus.
Your honors, I have two
Madame,
questions,
en fait, j'ai deux questions
to ask the accused.
Que j'aimerais poser aux accusés.
Kyo Sompon stated that he did not wish to evacuate and to kill people. So who made the decision to kill all of them?
Qui a choisi de tuer tous ces gens?
Number two,
et deux.
Kyo Sompon
mentioned
that he did not want to talk to those who did not want to listen.
A dit qu'il ne voulait pas parler à ceux qui ne voulaient pas écouter.
He mean that the victims, did he refer to the victims?
Faisait-il la référence aux victimes?
President.
Le président.
Thank you, Madame Chao Lang.
Merci,
the chamber wishes to inform you that after ascertaining the position of both accused on 8 January 2015 regarding the exercise of the right to remain silent. The chamber notes that the two accused maintain their expressed opposition unless and until such time as the chamber is expressly informed otherwise by the co-accused or their counsels. It is therefore incumbent upon them to inform the chamber in a timely and efficient manner should the accused resolve to waive the right to remain silent and be willing to respond to questions by the bench or relevant parties at any stage of the proceedings. As of today, the chamber is not informed that the co-accused have changed their expressed position and thus agreed to provide their responses to the questions.
The chamber would
like to adjourn its hearing today, and it may continue the hearing tomorrow on the 2nd September 2015. The chamber will continue to hear the victim impact statements of 2TCCP 993 and 994 in relation to Trappeng-Tmore worksite, said the President.
Du chantier du barrage de Trappeng-Tmore.
Thank you, Madame Chao Lang. Thank you for coming here to express the impact and injuries you said you experienced during the Democratic Cambodia, in particular in relation to the 1st January Dam worksite court officers. Please work with Westu to send Madame Chao Lang back to the desired destination or to any place where she is intending to go. Thank you, Madame Chai Maridain.
Et merci beaucoup, Madame.
You may not be accused. Security personnel are instructed to bring back the two accused
garde de sécurité, veuillez
to the detention facility of the ECC and have them returned tomorrow at 9 a.m. The court is now adjourned.